9/11 is seared into the memory of Rose Judkins of Apple Valley.
The most horrible crack of metal against metal. And we knew that wasn't right. Stuff coming down from the sky, papers, soot, this, that. And we just started running.
Rose and her brother Dwayne both worked at Morgan Stanley in 5 World Trade Center, one of the shorter buildings next to the Twin Towers. After the initial shock, Rose realized she hadn't seen her brother.
I had coworkers that were trying to pull me away. It was like, we can't stay here anymore. Let's go, let's go. And I'm like fighting them. I'm like, I can't leave without my brother. That second plane hit, I found him, hugged him, cried, so happy to see him. We start walking across the Brooklyn Bridge.
Friday night, a friend was watching Lester Holt on nightly news when she caught a fleeting glimpse of a photo of a shocked Rose and brother Dwayne making their way back to Brooklyn.
I've never seen that picture. I sent it to my brother and he was like, we were trying to get away. We didn't know people were taking pictures of us. And just that view of the towers behind us with my agenda and my little book in my hand.
Did you ever read that book?
No, I didn't want to read the book.
Rose wasn't done fighting for her life that day. Since then, she has survived breast cancer twice.
I think more about gratitude and being grateful that God has kept me through so many different things. And obviously, I have stuff to do.
No doubt. In Apple Valley, John Croman, Care 11 News.
Wow. After 20 years, you realize you see yourself on the national news. Interesting. Rose has a sister and another brother who worked on Wall Street that day and were caught in the dust cloud after the tower collapsed. But they, too, made it home safely. Amazing.